The poem is entitled, "There Were My Brothers Too."
Okay.
And it reads, "My name is Bakari Kujabi. My name is Ismail Abah. My name is Amadou Nyang Jao. See, I am the brother who got shot and killed for defending my home. I am the citizen who democracy could not protect. I am the son whose fundamental human rights could not save. I am the husband who the constitution of this nation was not written for. I am the father whose blood is in the hands of the government that you and I fought to put in place. I am the hopelessness this government represents. I am the nightmare this country has turned into. See, if anger had a face, then you are looking at him. If shame had a voice, then you are listening to him. For my heart burns with greed, but my voice is caged in the grave with a bullet to the chest for reason my killers can't even explain. I am what will happen to you if you don't stand against what happened to me. My name is Suleiman Jame. My name is Seni Sonko. My name is Dauda Dafe. And I am asking, when did life become so meaningless in this country that the police don't need a reason to open fire on unarmed civilians? When did we become so powerless that we can't even peacefully protest to protect our homes or speak as free men? When did democracy become a government of lying, stealing and killing? When did freedom become some kind of Greek god that requires human sacrifice that we must try to defend? For what sins must we repent? What crimes have we committed? What laws have we broken that we don't even deserve to be arrested and be taken to court, but must be sought where we stood point blank of personal with no regard, remorse or respect? My name is Babacar Diop. My name is Lamine Camara, and my name is Alhaji Omar. And I ask, is this truly the democracy we vote for? Is this the freedom we laid our lives on the line for? Is this the new Gambia we pledged for? Is this the dream we sold ourselves for? This was not the will of God, no. This was the will of security officers who have no respect for human life. So correct me if I'm wrong, but RIP we say never again. RIP we vote for change. RIP we say the peace, we have to peace our pains. It's like Jame killed our voices, but I gave them back to us, but he doesn't listen or care about what we say. So I speak for the brothers they slave. I could be the one bleeding on the floor tomorrow, but until that bullet hits my head, my voice will echo with the cries of refugee Gambian for the rights violated, with the families of the victims for the lives perpetrated. For so far, the only thing we have been able to change are the names and the faces of the people abusing the power we give. The people who are supposed to be protecting us will choose to abuse us instead. We simply exchange dictatorship for incompetence, and the result is the same. We get arrested and sent to jail for peaceful protesting. I stand with the youth of Gunju too. We get blocked off exercise and our freedom speech. I speak for Dr. Sise too. And now we are getting shot and killed in the streets for defending our homes. In just less than 4 years, Barrow and his government have managed to perfectly replicate almost everything it took Jame 22 years to do to us. So you tell me, who is worse than who? Because right now, it is the blood of our brothers that's been spilled by a system we created. A system that is run by leaders whose hunger for power, fame and fortune is so great that they are capable of trading the sovereignty of this nation and its people to foreign aid. So no, we are not free, no. We are not safe, no. This is not democracy, no. This is not freedom, no. This is not new, no. This is not liberation, so no. There is no change. The new Gambia is nothing more than a political propaganda, so we are, because we are still being abused, we are still being oppressed, except this time, it is not under Jame. This time, it is under the leadership of a man you and I created. This time, it is under the leadership of President Barrow. So yes, the blood of our brothers is in our hands too. What are you gonna do about it?
It's my home. Black is my color. But killing is not my nature. Cause we love freedom, torture our young. We train and nurture peace and unity, our living gesture. The God is the devil, so we can all do better. War is the evil, so we can stop it together. The killer is the sinner, but he is my brother. He does not love what he is doing. But since the university degree can't get him a job, he knows no better. The victim is my sister, and that was not meant safety for my mother. My father is a farmer, I'm not an undertaker. My home is a sanctuary, not a cemetery. I am a child. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Alhaji Amadiala. I'm a student of Armitage Senior Secondary School. And I'm a poet. So, for the event, the poem I would love to perform is dedicated to the ex-students of Armitage Senior Secondary School. And this is entitled "The Patriotic Songs of Armitage." And it reads, I stand here with a vision, but I have a mission. So, grant me your permission to make this admission. See, it is not a confession, but my sincere submission that Armitage is the oxygen that we breathe, the blood that flows in our veins, the sun that brightens our days, and the moon that illuminates our nights. See, if Armitage was a woman, I propose marriage. If Armitage was a jail cell, I choose imprisonment. For Armitage is the foundational block that built the Gambia. So blessed are the patriotic sons of Armitage, for they are not merely ex-students, indeed they are legends and home lovers, and today is a manifestation of their patriotism. Blessed are the patriotic sons of Armitage, but they truly understood what it means to be ex-students. They deprived Mother Armitage of rest, sleep and comfort, and today Mother Armitage's heart is filled with joy, knowing that those restless days and sleepless nights were never in vain. Blessed are the patriotic sons of Armitage, for they endure the most extreme circumstances just to keep their heads above water. And today we all gather here to celebrate their generosity and magnanimity. And blessed are the patriotic sons of Armitage. For she fed them with knowledge, she clothed them with hard work and determination, she centered them with patience, she educated them with wisdom, and graduated them with blessings. Blessed are the patriotic sons of Armitage. But today is the realization of a dream, the fulfillment of a promise, the accomplishment of a goal, and the execution of a duty. All Armitageans owe to Armitage. So viva 91 class of Armitage Senior, viva Armitage Excellence, and viva Armitage Senior Secondary School. Thank you.